To add an image, we need to go to the big green button again, hit Insert Stimuli and Images. This will bring up a file picker, and there are several ways to upload an image. You can, you know, pick from your local hard drive. We have several integrations, such as your cached images on Cognilab, and some other images from web, you know, Dropbox, your Google Drive, etc. Box. I think this is OneDrive, Evernote, Flickr, Facebook, and Instagram. But let's just choose an image that I have on my hard drive. So this is a facial recognition image from a previous study. So let's just hit that and let that populate. So great, we have this image here. If you click and drag, you can, you know, reposition the image. There's a little gray corner here. If you click on that and drag it, you can resize it manually. So let's just leave it in the middle for now and move over to the properties. Now, the first thing you'll notice is that it's visible. This is probably desirable. I mean, you can make your image invisible if you want it, you know, only for yourself. The second option is to make it clickable. And this would be you know, useful in a question that's asking the participant to choose between several images, almost like a multiple choice question. And we have a couple options here. When we make an image clickable, you can select go to next trial on click. That means once the user clicks on the image, it will trigger the next trial to begin. So it's like an automatic, it's like a de facto move on to the next question type of thing. And the second thing that you are given the option is a visual cue. And what would happen when someone clicks on that image is a yellow box would appear around the image to indicate that it has been clicked on. For the sake of this demonstration, we're just going to unclick go to next trial. But if we move down this path here, we have data that we can modify, so we can capture data. We can make this question mandatory in order to proceed or not mandatory. We can rename the variable that it will capture this data. So we can say, you know, female face number one or something. And if we want to capture response time and it's measured in milliseconds, we just need to click capture. So let's move down to the bottom here. There's a few more things that we can modify. Let's just add a border around the image. And let's display this to, and let's modify the time display setting. So what time display shows is it'll show the image after a certain number of milliseconds, let's say 1500, and it will hide the image after a specified amount of time. But for this demonstration, let's just leave it blank and open-ended. So if you leave it open-ended, it will just continue for infinity. So let's see what this looks like from the participant's point of view. First, we need to add a button so that the experiment knows not to loop back on itself. So let's save that and preview. So that first pause was the 1.5 seconds time display. There was a delay there. You notice that there's a border around it. If I go hover over, there's a little bit of shadow. And if I click, it turns yellow. There's a yellow box around it. So that's essentially the image and couple different behaviors. So I clicked on it a few times and let's hit next. And what it'll show is that, yes, someone clicked on this image, female face number one, and it took that person 22,000 milliseconds, so 22.7 seconds. And that's it for images.